We are going to present for the first time a new initiative we call the Future 8. And you're going to hear it from four representatives or partners who've been part of the meetings of Future 8. And what it is about is celebrating the telecom legacy in Israel and around the world, and also doing some deep thinking into finding new growth engines for that industry. So I would like to invite Mr. Eden Bertal, Director General of Ministry of Communication, who was also an advisor for investment companies in China and around the world in the field of telecom. I would also like to invite Ms. Daphna Steinmetz, who is Chief Innovation Officer and Vice President of Strategy and Partnerships at Amdocs. And of course, Dr. Barak Aronson from Tel Aviv University, who just made Aliyah back from NYU. Barak is an expert of collaborative strategy in the field of technology. And we will start with Eden.
From here.
Yes, each of the speakers will have 5 minutes. Okay, it's going to be very fast, so.
Okay, shalom to everyone. In the short time that I will speak, I'll try to address two challenges. I'm not speaking about the pride of the Israeli high-tech sector or the startup nation, as everybody speaks about, since I think this is this audience, this remarkable audience, wish to hear something with some input to think about after the few minutes I'll talk. Beforehand, I would like just to mention or to thank the organizers and especially the young lady, Yael Shani, who organized this event for a few years. And if you want to understand Israel, just think about young lady that decided this happening should take place, and it happened. I can't understand how come she made it. I ask her this question frankly, and I'm not sure I'm clear about it, but something about the initiative of young Israelis can take your dreams and make it happen in a way that nobody can think about. And that's why I'm quite optimistic about our future. Having said that, and thank you, Boaz, for hosting this great event at Cisco. The two points I would like to mention, and I'm sure I cannot discuss them thoroughly, is I have a local concern and I have an international concern. My local concern is about a tendency that I think that Israelis tend to go after the quick kill, and it was always this situation. To sell a company too early, to have the exit strategy too early, and not to grow up large-scale companies, this is something that have been discussed throughout the years more and more, and I don't have anything else to add to that. What I would like to mention is that recently we started to notice another tendency, which is much more dangerous and much more risky to our future. The quick kill is not to sell your company too early and not to grow it. The quick kill is to move from real R&D based on real science to start to develop in 6 months and with $500,000 applications to be sold in the App Store or Android, and leaving aside the real research that a real economy should be based upon. Our economy is based, and Chaim Shani has just joined us, and he knows all angles from the industry and from the government. He also searched this issue thoroughly with great worries, because And we spoke about it in the past. Our strength in the ICT sector is based on R&D that was based on past education, past R&D in the universities, special units of the Army, the R&D of the Army. And all of that led us to real R&D, to real companies, to real innovations. To change that with quick kill, quick dollar of an applications will lead us to lose our competitive edge in a couple of 3 years. Applications can be developed by everyone all over the world. It's not something we can base our R&D, our development, our economy. We should go back to square one and to educate our youngsters, not to run after the quick kill, not run after the quick dollar, but to go back to real science, real R&D, real innovation. I know from the government side, especially from Chaim activities during his tenure, that he paid great attention to that, and the government changed a lot in the system of organizing the whole world of higher education, R&D, chief scientist, everything starting to be centralized from one core place in the Ministry of Finance and as a very important place of designing and planning the future. I think it was a very important first step, but it's not enough. The government should pay more and more attention to this tendency, and also you guys. You have to be aware of that risk, of the youngsters going after the applications world and not to the real R&D world. And for that, I ask you to pay attention, and I'm sure that more thorough discussion can be held somewhere else and in some other times. The second concern I would like to share with you is a global one. I call it the paradox of innovation. From the last 2.5 years in the position, I learned that a lot of R&D activities and other business activities all over the world is at the higher level of the food chain. Cloud computing, applications, new services, everything you speak about in your conferences, you hear more and more development or future visions about great developments, great solutions, all of them based on one assumption, that someone will be there to invest in the infrastructure, in the networks that must deliver your results. Because without very high speed, ultra speed networks, you will not be able to sell your products and services. And nobody is paying attention to that all over the world. This is not a local problem. This is a global issue. Everybody is looking for the margin. The margin are made on added value. The added value is in the software or other stuff which is at the upper levels or in the food chain. And less incentives or interest are for investing in the networks. And what we see, I believe, is as we already see that happening, but we are going to face it in the next 2, 3, 4 years, that all of you guys and the other American large-scale companies that know how to milk the food chain and taking the great advantage of paying royalties nowhere, paying taxation nowhere, but selling their great services and products and taking the big portion of the money. I don't want to mention names, but we can say Google and Amazon and Facebook, and doesn't matter, and you can find more and more companies that are really making great, great revenues and great margins, but they are letting someone else to invest in the infrastructure, in the networks. And what will happen that the owners, the operators, they don't have the incentive to invest anymore. So they stop investing. The networks are not going to be developed. And without tremendous changes in investing in those networks, fourth generation in the mobile world and FTTH in the fixed line, I think most of the companies are building their vision and I would say their future on false assumption. And the only thing I would like you to think about is who is going to take care of this basic assumption that you take it for granted, but nobody is going to develop it instead of you. That's all.
Hello, everyone. My name is Daphna Steinmetz, and I'm the Chief Innovation Officer and Vice President for Strategy and Partnership at Amdocs. Good afternoon, and thank you very much for staying here when there is such good coffee outside. First, I would like to commend Yael Shani for the fantastic production that she's raised here. It's very hard to be a modern. So I'm here to talk about the Future 8. I'm very glad to be one of the first people representing companies that joined the Future 8. Future 8 is all about building... Future 8 is a newly conceived initiative. It's all about building an open source, but at the level of ideas and trends and vision. And as Adi said, it's not a pool party. It takes a long time to build a vision and find out what is the next big things or many big things. And we need some multidisciplinary thinking of many companies to do it right and to promote the industry with some Zionistic angle. Why we do that, there is a saying that no man is an island, and with the velocity of change and the pace of innovation in our times, no company can do a real significant step without sharing ideas and collaborating with the other companies. This is the reason why Future 8 has been established. And we already see many companies joining this initiative, like Microsoft and Google and IBM and Alcatel-Lucent and many others. Verizon, of course. Thank you. And we as the startup nation, we tend to take it for granted that entrepreneurs are everywhere and new ideas are coming all the time. But really the truth is, that successful entrepreneurs are not growing on trees, and we need to leverage this human fortune and make, with a collaboration, good things with this. So the mission of the Future 8 is to grow new growth engines, and we need to do it together. We need to grow a new technology, we need to prosper our businesses, and I encourage all of you to join. We are looking forward to hear more people talk about that. Thank you very much.
שלום, תודה רבה שבאתם ותודה רבה ליעל שארגנה את הכל. Oh, sorry. I want to thank you everyone for coming, and I want to thank Yael Shani for organizing this wonderful event. And without her, the Future 8 Think Tank Research Institute would not be alive today. And is being in the, its initiative process. But just a few minutes, I have a few minutes, and I just want to talk 1 minute about myself so people would know who I am. I worked at KPMG, CPA in Israel. I did my PhD in strategic management and organizational theory in Toronto, in Canada, and I saw a representative of the embassy, Canadian embassy here. Wonderful school. I do my research is on agglomerations, networks, collaboration, competition, and all those. I look at technologically oriented firms. Organizations, both startups as well as the more established firms, and how they compete and collaborate. And what it seems like, more and more people, more and more companies need to collaborate, because alone we can't do things. And I'll explain further more in a few minutes. And after I did my PhD, I went to work at NYU, Stern, and then a year ago I came to join Tel Aviv University in the hope of fostering here also some strategy and technology. And given that already technology is available here, maybe move things a bit a step forward. Like Eden said, in the past we didn't have companies, big companies, and not a lot of startups wanted to continue and develop into more mature organizations. Maybe in the future will be different. So things are rapidly changing in the cost of the technologies in the mobile industry. The R&D costs are going up. The time to enjoy the benefits from the technologies is going down because of the rapid changes in technologies, and hence one company cannot do it alone. And this is why I think Eden sees all the new entrepreneurships going into things that are easier to do when you're doing it alone and not when you're collaborating. Yeah, and Alnai initiated the Future 8, and she came to me and said, "You have some background in collaboration strategy, let's do something and work with big companies, and then later on add all the good great startups that we have here in Israel to maybe create something that not only will impact the Israeli economy but also have some impact maybe on worldwide trends and economy in the telecommunication industry." And collaboration is not a necessity. It's a necessity, it's not a luxury. Unfortunately, because of the rapid cost, IBM in the past in the semiconductor industry already realized the problems. In the semiconductor industry happened to experience the same thing that the telecom industry is experiencing now. The cost of R&D were going up, the benefits from the technology, the timing was going down, and one company could not go alone. It could either collaborate with competitors or everyone could compete until they eventually die and get out of the market. They embarked on a radical collaboration model. They had lots of experience with that, and we have representatives of IBM today here. They might later on tell us more about this collaboration, but eventually they benefited so much from this collaboration, created platforms that could be used by all competitors. Everyone could design and generate new technologies, new things, all from the same technology, same technological platform. And it was so successful that IBM later on moved into also a manufacturing alliance. It was able to add more and more people, more and more companies to the original Sony, Toshiba, and other big companies that were their competitors, and was very successful in doing that. And all those companies are still with us today because they also chose to collaborate. Our methodology here is we're analyzing the current trends, the researches that are done about the market. We then talk to the firms, hopefully more than once. Some firms that we even talk, our aim is to talk once a month. And we understand their needs. What are their issues? How they perceive things? How they see the challenges that are facing the future in their niches and maybe in other niches. Together we aggregate it and we create forms, consolidated forms. The last think tank included people from Amdocs, Cisco, SanDisk, Motorola, Lucent. Everyone coming there to work together and collaborate. Everyone there is there to work hard and help in fostering a better future and collaboration. The purpose of this is to not only create and understand the trends and understand what is the challenges and how do we face the challenges, but hopefully in the future move to more R&D collaboration, help firms get a better focus on where they need to go and hopefully, maybe if things go better, then maybe form more R&D collaboration between the current competitors, maybe invest in some collaborative efforts in R&D to help create more better infrastructure and help more R&D, the true R&D, like Eden said. Definitely the other R&Ds are as true, and I, as opposed to Eden, I think they should flourish as well and in parallel to others. The methodology, we looked at human factors and the current technology platforms and other issues, all issues that will be elaborated probably later on today. I wanted to thank Yael Shani and everyone, and we look forward to your collaboration.
Okay, the next two speakers and we'll need the stage, so thank you all. Okay, what we did in Futurate in the meetings that that we held was to analyze the trends based on the four dimensions of cloud, content, security, and infrastructure. And following this, we also analyzed it on three dimensions. One is called the human factor, the other is the technology, and the third is macro social and socio-demographic trends that are changing the world that we live in today. And facing these dimensions, we started to talk about some mutual challenges that we see. You heard some of the challenges from Eden and from Daphne.